Good afternoon to you. Mark Suttoth, HurricaneTrack.com, here with your Hurricane Pro and HD video blog regarding Hurricane Joaquin really today. Let's take a look at the satellite picture. Very well-defined Category 3, almost Category 4 hurricane down in the Bahamas, unfortunately, for them. And it's going to be a prolonged period of winds of hurricane force and higher, maybe 100 miles per hour in some locations. It's kind of hard to get these reported winds that are in a hurricane down to the surface everywhere. So you get higher gusts here and there. And for the Bahamas, unfortunately, the main thing is that it's going to be a very prolonged event. You can see the hurricane has a very well-defined central dense overcast, fairly well-developed outflow shield around it, and very cold cloud tops as indicated by the reds and the occasional dark grays in there indicating minus 70 to minus 80 and lower cloud top temperatures. Very, very cold, and that means that it's intense. And so here's the Bahamas, the eye and the eye wall wobbling around in here between some of these islands in the central Bahamas, and unfortunately it's going to take a little bit of time for this to move away. Now the 11 o'clock advisory showed a very slight change in the forecast track for Joaquin over the next few days. You've probably heard a lot about the GFS and the American generated models and the European ECMWF model. And you remember yesterday this was coming up into the Delmarva region, Chesapeake Bay, maybe North Carolina, and now it's looking a lot more like Joaquin will turn and eventually kind of head out to sea here, and this whole track is more than likely going to start shifting more and more off to the right or the east with time, because the European model over the last several days has been very persistent in bringing Joaquin out and away from the U.S., whereas the U.S. generated models were more like this, and now we're starting to see a little bit more convergence. And I can show you that here. This is the very latest GFS run from 12Z today, and there's Joaquin represented in the 500 millibar field, about the middle part of the atmosphere. And here's the cutoff low that's developing over southern Alabama, the nice ridge of high pressure sitting out over the Atlantic. But then there's this little bit of a weakness right in here, some of the leftover energy from Ida. And so this ridge is not quite as strong as it would be if this wasn't here. If this wasn't here, I think that Joaquin would easily get pulled in to the southern part of the mid-Atlantic states or the southeast states proper. South Carolina could have even been in play if it weren't for this sort of erosion here. This is kind of like a sinkhole, so to speak. If this wasn't here, I think that Joaquin would hit the United States, almost guarantee. So here it is, 24 hours out, so this is valid tomorrow morning. This is Saturday morning, Sunday morning, and so at this point, instead of it coming up and then pinwheeling in, you can see it's getting pulled out as the ridge gives way just enough to allow this to get pushed out to sea instead of being swung into the United States. And you do have building heights here over Canada, but probably not going to be enough to block this and send it back in like we saw with Sandy 3 years ago. It does try to make a little bit of a northward bend at 96 hours, but then again at 120 hours. This is valid this coming Tuesday morning. It is well to the south of even Nova Scotia here. And then we have sort of this leftover following behind nor'easter kind of deal from the upper trough and the cutoff low. Now, even without Joaquin in the picture, folks in the eastern United States here, mainly from New Jersey south into parts of South Carolina, right down the I-95 corridor, looking at a tremendous amount of heavy rainfall over the next few days. River flooding is going to be a big problem. Coastal flooding from the onshore flow and the gradient between Joaquin and that strong high pressure coming out over the Atlantic from Canada. This whole region through here, the New Jersey coastline, down through the Delmarva region, especially the Outer Banks, and then through the beaches, Wrightsville Beach, Myrtle Beach, down to Charleston. I think this entire region is going to fill in with very heavy rainfall, not directly related to the hurricane at all, as it should be passing well offshore here, but its presence and sending these big waves back in, swells, combined with the onshore flow that's going to be setting up. I'll draw that in red. We're going to have this tremendous onshore flow. That's going to cause enough problems as it is, so I think folks should feel very, very fortunate that as of now, it looks like, for the most part, and things can change, I know that, but you know, at this point it's starting to look like Joaquin is going to be a non-impacting directly event kind of situation for the U.S. coast, but there will be some indirect issues to deal with, especially the swells and the high surf that it generates, combined with this sort of strong pressure gradient northeast flow. But the hurricane itself looks like it's going to move safely away from the United States. That does not mean it is going to. It looks like it's going to. So I guess try not to use hope as a planning tool. We can hope that it does continue to do that trend away from the U.S. And if it doesn't, then you had best be ready. But so far, the trends are towards that European model solution of Joaquin staying away from the United States. All right, well, that's it for me for today. I'm Mark Suddoth, again, for HurricaneTrack.com, and, of course, Hurricane Pro and HD. Not sure when I'll have another update again. We're debating, my team and I, who had assembled for a possible field mission for Joaquin. We may tackle this other situation, the flooding and the possible coastal effects from this onshore flow that I talked about. So I may be able to post a couple of field reports to Hurricane Pro and HD over the weekend, so stay tuned for that.